How's it going, everyone? CJ from On The Grow here, and today I'm going to be comparing some fluorescent full spectrum 54 watt grow lights to some Barina T5 20 watt LED shop lights. These are just garage lights, and we're going to see how they grow some kale microgreens, so stay tuned for the video. All right, you guys, so like I stated in the intro of this video, today what we're gonna be doing is another lighting experiment. If you guys are new to this channel, what we like to do is a lot of experiments testing out how we can affect the growth of microgreens and try to get the best product that we can get, the healthiest, most juiciest microgreens. And we also teach people how to grow microgreens as well as quite a few other things. We're starting to move into houseplants and things like that. So if this is something you're interested in, please stick around because we got some awesome content coming. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and talk about this experiment a little bit and go back and do a little bit of story time here. So 10 days ago, what I did is I took 4 trays and I filled them each with 6 cups of coco coir per tray. And then I seeded it with 20 grams of kale, specifically lacinato. I don't know how to pronounce it. It's dino kale, and it is also, I think, like a Tuscan black kale or something like that. Either way, I seeded 20 grams per tray of this. After we seeded all these trays, we then watered it with a slight antifungal, and then we put this into a 3-day germination period. Normally we do 4 days, but after the 3 days with the 14 pounds of weight on top, we saw that everything was growing so well that we just put it directly into the light. There was no blackout whatsoever. We did not need to stretch this crop because it was growing very aggressively and really, really solid. Once it was introduced to the light, we began bottom watering it with Ocean Solution 2-0-3 mixed into our tap water at 0.5 ounces per gallon. We have a 3-gallon reservoir, so that is 1.5 ounces that we mix into that reservoir. And then we pH balance it to the 5.8 pH range. These trays then spent 6 full days in the light, and today is their 7th day underneath these lights, and they've been under there for a few hours now. What I need to do is I need to get all these trays pulled off the shelf, and we'll take a close look at the appearance of each one of these. Before we get these pulled off, I just want to quickly show. So the yellow labeled trays are the 2 kale trays that were underneath the 3 Barina T5 LEDs. And then the 2 red labeled trays are the 2 trays that went underneath the 2 Sunblaster T5 high output fluorescent grow lights. Whenever you pull microgreens off of a shelf, you really want to scoot your trays over because you can see how they're touching down this middle. If you just pull it forward, it's just going to drag all those cotyledons together and you're going to rip a bunch off. So it really helps it separate them. Okay, so I've got all these trays pulled off and everything is looking pretty dang comparable. And I'm very happy with the growth on all of these so far. I mean, I'm loving the consistency. It looks like really solid germination across all the trays. The growth looks very even and consistent. I will say this one fluorescent has a slightly odd area right here. But other than that, the rest of the tray is looking really, really happy. Okay, so let's go ahead and dive into a comparison on the appearance of these at first glance. First thing I'm gonna do is turn off this grow light right here because this pink light casts a crazy coloration on all this. Okay, so if you guys will remember, the 2 red label trays are fluorescent and the 2 yellow label trays are our LED lights. So starting over here on our fluorescent trays, like I said, we have this slightly weird area right here on tray number 1. But overall, the growth on these cotyledons and the coloration looks really nice. I'm loving the greens on this. It is a nice deep green that looks very, very healthy. We have a little bit of stretching to one side, and I think that this was the tray that was on the end. So usually what happens is whenever you have that, you'll have a kind of a weaker growth on one side of this tray versus the one that has it's positioned more in the middle of the shelf. You can see how much more rounded and well grown it is. And with the second tray, same thing. I mean, I'm loving the coloration on this cotyledons. The canopy looks very nice and healthy. The rounding to it looks really solid. We have a very uniform growth going on here. And as for coloration of stems, I am seeing like a slight purple tinge down here at the base of these stems. Oh yeah, here's one that looks really good right here. It's kind of hard to get that to focus there. I'll have to take my word on it. So we got some purple down there that looks really good on this fluorescence. Overall, I'm very happy with the growth on these fluorescent trays. Maybe slightly taller than I would like, but I think that's because our grow space has been hotter than usual. On to the LEDs. These as well are looking super, super happy. I'm really loving the growth on these. And if we compare it side by side with the fluorescence, it seems to be nearly identical with the height And the growth overall, I'm not really noticing a whole bunch of differences here between the coloration and these seem to be a lighter green than these. I don't know if you guys can really see that. Hold on, don't focus on my hand. Yeah, so these do appear to be like a slightly, it looks a little bit more neon coloration compared to these, which seem to be a bit more muted and darker, which could be healthier growth or healthier growth. I don't really know. We'll figure out soon enough. Again, overall, loving the growth on these two trays. I think that the LEDs have done a really great job here. Let's see if we got some of that purple. So we do have some of that purple here as well. So that is actually pretty abundant on these LED trays, a lot of this purple coloration down here. It seems like it's a little bit more prevalent. Nope, yep, there it is. Cool. On these LED trays compared to the fluorescents, like I'm just not seeing as much of that purple coloration. You guys see that? Interesting. I guess we'll find out more as soon as we harvest. So what I'm going to do right now is actually ask you guys to go ahead and smash that thumbs up button, because it really does help out our YouTube channel. If you guys are feeling extra generous, be sure to click that subscribe button and the notification bells. That way you guys get notified whenever we release new videos. So let's go ahead and harvest these. I will set up the camera over here so you guys can kind of just check it out from over the shoulder and watch this thing get harvested. Beep. You can see how pretty those little stems are. I don't know if you guys can see that purple right there, but that is some good looking stemmage. Any like little stragglers like this, you just go like this and they'll fall out. Tickle the roots. Not supposed to taste it yet. All right, if you guys don't already and you grow a lot of microgreens, get yourself a little bucket that you can just throw compost stuff into, because it really helps out, as you can see, all the mess that's created from harvesting and stuff. You just swipe this into your compost bucket and then toss this into your compost or just into your yard instead of into a trash can where it'll never actually return to the earth. All right, so same thing for first glance. I'm seeing a little bit of that purple down here at the base of the stem, but not as much as I was kind of seeing on those LEDs. I do feel like this one has a little bit more than that first tray of the fluorescent group though. Overall, again, I think it's really beautiful looking and I'm really excited with that product. Okay, I finished harvesting all four of the trays. Let's go ahead and take a close look at the harvest weights again and the appearance of these crops. Okay, so I have all of the product laid out here in front of me. We've got our LED harvested bag over here and then our fluorescent harvested bag over there. These two trays, or these two groups right here, are the LEDs, and then these two groups right here are the fluorescents. As for the fluorescent side, we had a harvest weight of 295 grams for one tray and then 305 grams for the second tray. As for the LED groups, the first tray had a harvest weight of 289 grams, and then the second tray had a harvest weight of 321 grams. 289 plus 321 equals 610 total for the LEDs divided by 2 equals 305 gram average for the LED side. 295 plus 305 equals 600 grams total for the fluorescent. So far LEDs have won an overall harvest weight, divided by 2, 300 gram average for the fluorescent groups. So that was crazy close in the harvest weights there. And the overall winner for the harvest weight is the LED side, with a 5 gram higher average than the fluorescent side. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the appearance. So again, we got LEDs and fluorescent. Starting on the fluorescent side, I think that the growth here is very beautiful and I love it overall. I'm really happy with the stem coloration. I'm not seeing any signs of disease or pathogens or anything like that. The coloration is really quite nice on it. Let's go ahead and flip it here so we can take a look at the cotyledons. And the cotyledons are a really nice green color. It is a deep green and it doesn't seem to have any light spots or too much of anything bad going on. So looking between the fluorescent group right here and the LEDs over here, it seems like the LEDs are almost just a little bit darker in their cotyledon coloration, which is actually quite surprising. As for the stems on the LED side, again, I think that they are really beautiful. We have a tiny bit of purple. Do I see any in here? I mean, there's just a very faint amount of purple here. And overall, it's just the same really solid looking happy growth. Okay, so as for the winner on appearance, I'm actually not seeing any here. I noticed a little bit more purple whenever I was harvesting the LEDs. So that was nice, but as I put them side by side, I'm not really seeing too much of a difference. So I think that the appearance here is just a draw overall. Now let's go ahead and move into a taste test. So I'm gonna call in a guest celebrity who has no idea which one of these trays are which or which one of these crops are which. So let me go ahead and get her pulled in here. Mandy, will you come here and taste some food? All right, so I found this random woman walking down the street and I asked her if she'd like to be a part of a microgreen taste test. And she said, what are microgreens? So I had to give her a little pitch that it's a very healthy crop that grows in 7 to 14 days and they're very nutritious. So ma'am, can you confirm that you've never known what a microgreen was before this moment?
I've never seen a microgreen before in my life.
So Mandy, if you would, just start digging in and I know what is what.
All right, first off, I have to say walking in here, I can smell that brassica flavor. So I think all your products probably really good because it smells really good. And I think let's start on this side. We're gonna do this one. Very light crunch and very mild flavor as well.
Okay, so first one you tasted was very light crunch, very mild flavor.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, coffee is actually really good for cleansing the palate. It's what a lot of people use for cleansing their noses whenever it comes to smelling perfume.
I'm gonna do this one.
Do it.
I feel like that one was kind of similar to the first one. Light flavor, light crunch. Yeah, I would say those two are pretty identical.
Okay,
yeah.
So the first two tastes are identical.
Mm-hmm. Now I'm grabbing from the third group.
Third group, yes.
Yes, I counted right.
She can count.
Yeah. A lot more crunch in that one. Flavor's still about the same though. So far, all three groups had basically the same flavor, but the texture was different.
Good to know. So all three groups have similar flavor, but the texture on that one was just a little bit crunchier.
Okay, and then now for the second group. More flavor, more crunch all the way on that one.
More flavor, more crunch on that one. Okay, so what's the winner then?
That second group.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I will say that the flavor is still pretty comparable. It was just like that slight just oomph. Oomph is my favorite description.
Slight oomph. There's a slight oomph. Okay, good to know. All right, thank you. You may continue your walk down the street. Okay, guys. So Mandy has said that her favorite was this tray right here, which is actually our second tray from our fluorescent group. So this was the T5 high output fluorescent trays right here, and she chose that second one as being the overall winner. As for all the flavor though, she said all of them had a very similar taste. The only difference was this one had a little bit more crunch and this one just had a little bit more oomph as she describes it for the second tray. So that fluorescent tray is the winner in flavor though. Most of them seem to be pretty comparable. Okay, so the last thing that I haven't talked about is the actual cost of running these lights and their PAR output and all the specs basically on the lights. So let's go ahead and talk about the top shelf first. So the top shelf was our Sunblaster T5 grow lights, which again were fluorescent. They were not LEDs. These were full spectrum in their coloration. There were two of them at $54.80 a piece, bringing the total for the two lights to $109.60. The PAR output for these two lights was about 60 to 95, depending on where we position the PAR meter on the shelf. The watt and amp per light is 52 watts and 0.64 amps per light, meaning that it costs a total of 21 cents per day to run these lights. The other lights were the Barina T5 LED shop lights. Now again, these are T5, they were 6500K and their light temperature. There were three of them at $6.67 a piece, which brings a total to $20.01 for all three of the lights to be on the shelf. The PAR output was a little bit higher at 75 to 85. So actually the Sunblasters had a higher total, or I guess a higher peak PAR output, but the PAR average was a lot better on the LED group, staying between that 75 to 85 compared to the 65 to 95 for the Sunblaster T5 grow lights. As for their watt and amps each, the LEDs pulled 19.6 watts a piece and 0.16 amps. And since there were three of them, that means it costs a total of 12 cents per day to run all three of these lights. And that is it for the actual light specifications. Now let's go ahead and talk about the total cost. So like I said, for the LEDs, it was 12 cents per day. And for the Sunblaster T5 grow lights, it was 21 cents per day to run the lights, which means for the LEDs, it was a total of 84 cents for the 7 days to run these lights. And on the fluorescent T5 grow lights, it was 21 cents per day, which brings a total to $1.47 to run these lights for the entire 7 days of this experiment. Now, right there, we have nearly doubled the cost of running these lights for the fluorescents compared to the LEDs. And I would say that the growth was actually pretty darn comparable between the two. Even though the winner for flavor was kind of the deciding factor there, that went to the Sunblaster, the fluorescent group. But the LEDs did a great job overall. Like Mandy said, all the flavors seem pretty consistent and very nice across the board. So as for the overall cost of running these lights, I feel like the LEDs is kind of the way to go. I really love the T5s. They don't put out as much heat. So that's something that I value in my grow space, especially in the summertime and spring and things like that, where I don't want these crazy hot temperatures in my grow space. I want to keep that for winter. So the fluorescents might be nice for winter. And that way you don't have to use a whole bunch of heaters or stuff like that. But again, it does cost more energy and it is a much, much higher upfront cost. Like I said, for those two fluorescent lights, $110 basically, compared to all three of those Barina T5 LEDs for 20 bucks. I mean, that's a massive difference to people. You can basically fill up the whole rack right there, or you could fill up the whole rack with three of those Barina T5s per shelf for the cost of just one level of that fluorescent T5 grow light. So now I have to choose an overall winner for this experiment. Personally, I'm gonna have to go with the LEDs just because they use so much less energy, way less upfront cost. If you use three of them per shelf and get a similar PAR output to the two fluorescents, then you're gonna get very similar growth. I didn't notice a huge difference between the 6500K temperature, which is the color rating on the light output for these LEDs, compared to the full spectrum of the fluorescents. I was gonna say something else, the fluorescent Sunblaster lights above it. All right guys, well that is it for this experiment. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. I'm gonna be testing out these fluorescent lights a lot more. I'm gonna be comparing them to actually these blurple lights. Let me go ahead and get those popped back on before I forget. Boop. So I'll be comparing these fluorescents, like I said, to these actual T8 LED grow lights from the same company, Barina, as the LED lights above it. And then also against these more powerful garage shop lights from Barina down here, which are T8s. So we'll see how these things will just stack up against all these. And what I did is I did my best to even out the PAR on all four of these shelves. So maybe I'll end up doing like a whole massive test where we'll do maybe two or four trays per shelf and just compare like a super overall master guide for each one of these lights compared to each other for like a full grow and a crop. We'll see about that. That'll be a lot of work to do that because it'll take forever to jot down each weight and everything like that and to talk about it individually. But it could be a lot of fun to really get like a master guide to all these lights. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to give us a thumbs up. If you dislike this video, give us a thumbs down. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the section below and we'd love to get those answered for you as soon as we possibly can. Our Instagram and our Facebook are both at On The Grow Farms. And our website is www.onthegrow.net. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Keep on believing. And I was trying to think of something with lights. Oh God, I couldn't think of a single light joke. We'll just leave it there. I feel sad now. Keep on believing and keep it lit.